Hello, and welcome to this short video tutorial on WebTree. We have recently updated WebTree to a more modern interface which offers new features and functionality. Although there's a new look and feel, the logic, philosophy, and login process have not changed. We recommend that you view the resources that are available on the Registrar's website prior to filling out WebTree. Once you've done so, you can access WebTree by clicking the link located on the page entitled Course Registration and WebTree Overview. Or you can go directly there by navigating to go.davidson.edu/webtree or registrar.davidson.edu/webtree. Follow the login instructions to begin. You will need to enter your Davidson email and password, and you will also be prompted to answer a multi-factor authentication prompt. Once you're logged in, you'll be taken to the home page where you can see the upcoming registration term and the dates during which WebTree will be open to you. If this is your first time logging into WebTree for this upcoming academic term, you will see a button that says Start WebTree. Clicking this takes you to a screen where you are required to enter your 4-digit WebTree PIN number. Incoming first-year students will have a PIN that is equal to the last 4 digits of their student ID number, and continuing students will use the PIN that is provided by your advisor each semester. This unlocks WebTree for you for the rest of the term and does not need to be used again. Your next stop is the Course Preferences page, where you'll have quick access to resources that help you build your WebTree, including DegreeWorks, the course catalog, course schedule, and schedule notes. Important information such as submission deadlines are displayed on this page, in addition to a button for each of the 4 trees. In the top menu, you'll see additional pages such as Review Choices, to view all of your choices once you're finished, as well as a page for WebTree Help if you need it along the way. You can use the Review Choices page to view your WebTree submission anytime for reference. Let's get started. To begin entering course preferences, click on tree number 1. Before you begin, read through this section at the top of the page to help you prioritize classes. When you're ready to pick your first course, click to open the menu at the top of tree number 1. This will open a pop-up course schedule that you can use to find and select courses. To search for a course, you have several options. First, search by subject and course number. If you want to find all Writing 101 courses, simply type in WRI space 101 to see all of your options. Or to find all computer science courses, type in CSC to find all courses with that subject code. You can also search by the course title, such as typing in the word music, or you can search by the instructor name. You can even search by the graduation requirements that the courses fulfill. For example, to locate all courses that satisfy the mathematical and quantitative thought requirement, you can search for MQRQ. Or search for JEC to find all courses that satisfy the Justice, Equality, and Community requirement. If you need a refresher as to which codes represent which requirements, they are available on the Registrar site under the page labeled Graduation Requirements. Lastly, you can search for courses in a given time slot if you need to plan around practices, rehearsals, and other commitments. We hope that these flexible search options make it easier for you to find the courses that you want when filling out WebTree. The search feature also includes interactive sorting on each of the columns in the pop-up schedule. Simply hover over the column headers in the schedule and use the small up and down arrows that appear to sort your column in ascending or descending order. And if you get to the bottom of the schedule without finding what you're looking for, just click the Show More button to load more rows into the schedule. You can also resize the columns by clicking and dragging the edges of the column headers if you need to make more text visible. When you found the course you want, just select it from the pop-up schedule to add it to your tree. Then, repeat the process until you have filled out your entire tree. Once you've filled out your tree, make sure to review your selections before you hit the Save Choices button. Notice how, in my case, several of my courses have notes on them, including prerequisites, time conflicts, and instructor permission requirements. In this case, there's a possible time conflict on Choice 4 for me. If I receive my Choice 1 and Choice 2 courses, but not my Choice 3 course, there will be a time conflict between Choices 2 and 4. If you need help understanding the flow of the choices, the small question mark buttons to the right of each choice will show you a small box that describes them, and if you want to clear one of your selections, you can click the X button and start over before entering a new course. Finally, when you click the Save Choices button, if you have selected any courses that require instructor permission or that have prerequisites, you will receive a pop-up that you must acknowledge that says you are aware of these requirements and certify that you meet them. After that, your first tree has been submitted, and you can view your selections either here on the Tree 1 page or on the Review Choices page. You also have an option when saving your tree to copy your choices from this tree to the next tree. It's a common strategy among students filling out WebTree to copy choices from tree to tree, and this option gives you a shortcut to do so. This means you don't need to find and select all of the same courses over and over again. Now, simply go through the rest of the pages to finish filling out WebTree. You'll notice that tree number 4 looks different because it has 10 course choices in a row. The process will run through each choice in a row until you have a full schedule. Consider using all 10 choices with a variety of options to increase your odds of getting a complete schedule. Once you've filled out all 4 pages and saved your choices, use the Review Choices page to scroll through your trees and verify that everything looks correct. After that, you're done with WebTree. Your choices have automatically been saved and will be used for registration after WebTree has closed. You can log into WebTree at any time to review your choices. Once WebTree is closed, you will no longer be able to update your choices, but you will still be able to see what you have selected. Thanks for watching, and we hope you enjoy the new and improved WebTree.